So you've probably heard the story of David and Goliath before, about how the little guy, the underdog, David, defeats the giant, the warrior, the bully, Goliath. And you might think this story is a fable. It's a myth. It didn't really happen. But there really was a David, and there really was a Goliath, and they really did meet face to face in a real valley, the Valley of Elah in Israel. Let's go. I mean, look at this place. There are hills for miles around. There are some trees and shrubs, but there are also some places where it's so rocky, it's hard to walk. We're west of the Dead Sea, past Bethlehem and Jerusalem, and it's kind of in the middle of nowhere. There is a small creek that runs down the middle of this valley with two slopes on either side. Picture this. The Israelites' army is on these slopes here. The Philistine army is on the other side, and their ranks split down the middle as the biggest, baddest soldier they have, Goliath of Gath, strides to the front line in full battle armor. And Goliath calls out, taunting them, making fun of them. The sound bouncing off the hills. Choose one of your men! Have him come down and face me! If he's able to fight and kill me, we'll become your slaves. But if I win and kill him, you will become our slaves and serve us! Can you imagine how loud Goliath would have been for the Israelites to hear him all the way across this huge valley? Over on the Israelite side, it's silent. Goliath keeps yelling across the valley, "Give me a man and let us do battle together!" But Goliath is 9 feet tall, and his armor alone weighed 125 pounds. Every Israelite soldier is thinking, even if I was brave enough or dumb enough to face Goliath, what would I do? How do you attack someone twice your size, covered in armor? Should I go for the legs? He'll crush me. I can't reach his chest or his head. It's hopeless. That's when David shows up. A kid, a shepherd who was supposed to be with his sheep. I mean, I'd be thinking, this job is for someone bigger, older, and stronger than me. You see, David has something the people bigger, older, stronger than him don't have. He has faith and courage that come from God. So David goes to the king, Saul, and says, "I will go and do battle with this Philistine." And Saul takes one look at David and is like, "You're too small. Nope, you need my armor." But it doesn't even fit. So David refuses to wear it. Then he says, "The Lord who rescued me from the lion and the bear will rescue me from the hand of this Philistine." David knew he could trust God because God had helped him fight battles with wild animals before. While David was protecting his sheep, God was protecting David. David runs down the hill into the Valley of Elah. He grabs 5 smooth stones from the creek and gets out his slingshot. And he faces Goliath, who's still trash-talking. David finally answers. "You come at me with a sword and spear, but I come to you in the name of the Lord who you have insulted." Then David ran straight at Goliath and the whole Philistine army. He's running and he grabs a stone from his pouch, slings it, and pow, knocks Goliath right in the forehead. Goliath falls on his face. David runs up, grabs the giant sword, and off comes Goliath's head. The Philistines are freaking out. No one expected Goliath to lose, and in a single moment, everything changes. Immediately, they flee. They literally run for the hills, and the Israelites, who just a few minutes ago were terrified, are now full of courage, and they follow David's lead and run after the enemy. This isn't just a story about a battle, though. This is a story of courage and trust. See, David had trust in God, and that trust gave him courage. And not only did David have courage, but his example gave courage to the people around him. He encouraged others. He put courage into them. There might be giants in your life, people who intimidate you, or maybe you're afraid something will happen to you, and God wants you to know you can trust Him. God can give you courage to face those giants. And not only does God want you to have courage, but He wants you to encourage other people. That giant you're facing might be your first step in becoming the leader God wants you to be. So, what about you? What giants are you facing? How do you think that might be affecting you, your family, and your friends? What's one way you can show God you trust Him and be courageous? You don't have to go to the Valley of Elah to have trust or show courage. God can give you courage today, right now. And that's true wherever you are.